Have you ever wanted to share photos with a friend and you want to hand them your phone so they can scroll through it, but you are a little afraid they might overswipe to something sensitive? Well, here's several tips for keeping those sensitive photos hidden and a great app that will prevent overswiping ever again. The first thing you should do is hide any sensitive photos from your camera roll that you don't want people to see right away. You can do this by tapping and holding on a photo and then the hide option. This will actually hide the photo from your camera roll and will prevent that photo from showing up on your lock screen rotation if you have a photo wallpaper. If you want to learn more about customizing your lock screen with photos, check out my video above. Now that that photo is hidden, no one can ever see it here in the camera roll. But if you go to your album view and scroll all the way down, you'll see there's a hidden option down here. When you go to see all of your hidden photos, it will actually require Face ID or to put in your iPhone passcode. If you can't unlock your phone, you can't unlock your hidden album. You can add as many photos as you want to that hidden album, and no one will see those photos as they're swiping through on your phone. And no, I won't be showing you my hidden photos. Now, the best way to prevent overswiping or someone going into another part of your phone while they're looking at your photos is to use an app called PeekaView. Peekaview is free to download or $5 to unlock all the features. But what you can do is here in the Gears or Settings menu, you can actually create a custom album. You can choose a current album you've already made from your trip or a recent vacation, but you can also do a custom album. With this custom album option, I can choose just specific photos that I want to share with someone, and when I hit done, these are the only photos that will appear in the PeekaView app. Now when you hand your phone to someone, they can tap and scroll through the photos that you've already selected, but it won't go past any photos, so they won't have access to your full photo library. Again, you can choose a specific album you've already created or choose photos on the fly. But as you've probably guessed, someone could just swipe to go home on your iPhone and then go to the Photos app or any other app on your device. This is where you need to use Guided Access. Guided Access is a feature you can enable in the Settings app on your iPhone. You can just search for Guided Access here at the top, and you'll find it under the Accessibility section. You can also just scroll down, go to Accessibility here, scroll all the way down, and then go to Guided Access. Enable Guided Access here, and then choose a specific passcode. You can also choose to unlock with Face ID, and this can be different than the passcode to unlock your iPhone or even screen time settings. For simplicity, I'll put all zeros just for the sake of the example. Don't do that yourself, actually set a good passcode for Guided Access. You can even choose how much time the phone will stay on once you've enabled Guided Access, and this toggle right here you really want to check. This will let you enable Guided Access quickly by triple clicking the side button or the button that puts your iPhone to sleep. You can also change the auto lock setting for your device. This is great for kids. If you want your kids to be able to watch something but not go into any apps or even touch anything on the screen, that's a great option to choose. Now that I have Guided Access enabled, I can actually go back into PeekaView. Here are the photos that I've chosen, and I'm going to triple click the side button. You'll now see that Guided Access was just enabled and the menu with the gear icon is automatically hidden. Now when someone's scrolling through my photos, they can scroll, they can pinch and zoom, see them up close, they can even go back and view them all, but they can't swipe to go home. It's actually impossible. Even the control center is disabled. Now they can't get to any other app on your iPhone and they can only see the pictures you want them to see. To disable Guided Access, you can triple click the side button again, put in your Guided Access passcode, and now you have full access to your phone again. Just tap end, and now you can swipe home, and you're good to go. You can also customize some of the features for Guided Access. Again, this is great for kids. I'm going to triple click to enable Guided Access again, and then let me triple click to disable, and on this screen, you'll see that there's an options menu. If I tap options, I can actually disable the side button and volume buttons, which I have disabled. Again, great for kids who might want to put the volume on full blast. You can actually disable the volume buttons, and this works on iPad as well, so they can't change the volume. You can enable motion like your screen rotation, which you might want to keep on if they're viewing photos. You can actually enable keyboards or disable them so nothing can be typed. And if you need to, you can even disable touch so no one can actually interact at all with the phone. You can also change the time limit here, so once you've enabled Guided Access, the phone will just lock after a certain amount of time. Once you've set your options, hit done. Now, if you want to get really fancy, you can actually create a shortcut automations on your iPhone that will automatically enable Guided Access every time you open the PeekaView app. To do that, I'm going to open the Shortcuts app on my iPhone. It's a free app. If you don't have it already, you can get it in the App Store. Then I'm going to go over to the Automations tab. I'll click the plus button at the very top to create a new automation, and I'm going to choose Create Personal Automation. Then scroll down and look for the option App. When I tap that, I can choose when app is opened and which specific app. Then I can scroll down or just search for PeekaView. I'll hit Done, and so this automation will run whenever I open the PeekaView app. Hit Next, and now I can search in the search box here at the bottom for Guided Access. You'll see a step show up, Start Guided Access. If I tap that, it will mean every time I open the PeekaView app, Guided Access will automatically enable. Now I want this to run without me doing anything, so I'm going to disable the Ask Before Running and tap Don't Ask. I also don't want a notification when it runs, And now I'll hit done. Now whenever I open the Peak of View app, guided access will automatically start. You'll see I've opened the app, guided access automatically started, and now no one can go home. They can only see the pictures I've chosen to select here in the Peak of View app. And if I need to get out of guided access mode, I can triple click the home button, put in my guided access passcode, and then hit end, and I'm good to go. And remember, guided access is great for kids, especially when watching or streaming content. Let's say you want your kids to be able to watch a movie but not change anything on the device. Well, here I can disable volume buttons and even touch. And now when I enable guided access mode, I'll resume it here. And now nothing works on the phone. I can tap the screen, nothing happens. I can't swipe up to go home. Even hitting the volume buttons doesn't do anything. Again, the only way to exit this mode is to triple click that sleep button, put in your guided access passcode, and then end the guided access mode. And now you have full access to your phone again. So that's how to prevent overswiping on photos and lock your iPhone to a single app. Again, great for sharing photos or especially when giving your device to a child. If you'd like to learn more about iPhone and iOS 17 tips, subscribe to the channel, hit that like button, and then check out this video right here. I talk about some of the new features coming to iPhone and iPad this fall with iOS 17. And if you'd like to check out my 100% Apple smart home with over 100 smart home devices, you can check out the video right here.